Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman's mega bank merger plan, if successful, will see 10 public sector banks merged into 4. I'm here with Soumya Datta, from the General Secretary of the All India Banking Officers Confederation. Hello, sir. Welcome. It's the Golden Jubilee year of bank nationalization. So such a decision coming at such a time, what does it imply and what is the impact going to be of this decision to merge all these public sector banks?
First, let us talk about bank nationalization. 19th of July, 1969, when 14 banks were nationalized. Now, we have to understand that it was a political will that announced the bank nationalization, and it was a prescription for the economic situation prevailing at that point of time. The economic situation of the country was in doldrums, and there were several suggestions that to improve the economic position, to make India self-reliant, banks have to be nationalized. The owners of the banks at that time were not in agreement with such a proposal. There was resentment inside Congress also, but despite such a syndicate working against the basic principles of nationalization, late Srimati Indira Gandhi announced nationalization as a prescription to lift out of the economic mess. Now, what happened after in this 50 years is absolutely that transformed the country. From total number of 8,262 bank branches that was there before the nationalization, it is now standing somewhere around 1,40,000 odd branches. And in between 1969 and 1991, there was a huge explosion of bank branches. The number almost increased to 60,220 in 1991. And out of which the number of rural banks increased to 35,206. It was only about 1,800 odd in 1969. So it was predominantly intended so that credit reaches out to the rural households through priority sector lending to the small and medium sized borrowers, artisans, villagers, and it transformed the entire country. It was only possible because of the vehicle of engine of growth was driven by the public sector banks. Now, this just compare the economic situation of the country. A recession has set in, although, I mean, the credit rating agencies and the various other agencies, they are terming this as economic slowdown. And now, to get out of the mess, to get out of the whatever the GDP numbers are coming, a new prescription has been put in place. You consolidate or amalgamate the public sector banks, that will generate this growth rate, that will stake us to the $5 trillion economy. Now, this is another political will of a different kind of working. It is reversing the entire process of nationalization, whatever it has been achieved through this glorious 50 years of journey, it's now being reversed. And this is the basic situation. So, this is, we are standing at such a cusp of time when the public sector banks, their heritage is being obliterated. We already experienced a merger of three banks into one entity last year, which All India Bank Officers Confederation had challenged the basic legality of the process. And the case is still there, still live in Supreme Court. Although supposedly the three banks have been merged into one entity, the Bank of Baroda. But what is the result of mergers? Why is it happening? We have some very interesting facts and figures. The first merger of public sector bank that ever took place, that was in 1993, when New Bank of India was merged with Punjab National Bank. And what happened was very strange. It posted a loss of first time, Punjab National Bank, a very strong bank, posted a loss of 96.90 crore in 1996. And RBI came out with a study report that was published, it's still available, you can check the RBI website. That was report was published on 4th of October 1999, where it said, I'll just read out, it said that the experience of bank mergers in the public sector has so far been limited to that of New Bank of India with a comparatively strong Punjab National Bank in 1993. The result of this merger was no different from the worst apprehensions expressed in that report. A direct result of the merger was that PNB, a strong bank with uninterrupted record of profits, had to record a net loss of 95.90 crore. The merger clearly demonstrated the futility of merging banks with different work cultures, ethic and skill levels of employees, whereby even the strong bank was put to severe stress. Till today, little evidence is available on any worthwhile advantage of having accrued to PNB from the merger. And this report is sacrosanct. Whatever has been stated is still sacrosanct. Now, our experience is that this merger is a deliberate attempt to destroy the social fabric of the country. What is happening in the defense sector? The ordnance factory employees and officers have had gone on an indefinite strike. The railway workers are agitated. They are also planning some action. What is happening with BSNL, MTNL, any public sector institution? All the institutions are under attack. And the attack is not limited to the banks, as I said. For the banks, despite all 12 banks being put under PCA, prompt corrective action by RBI, the market share of the banks, that is the trust the people of the country repose on the public sector banks, has not really dwindled. If I am not mistaken about the numbers, even at this point of time, around 67 of the total deposits belong to the public sector banks, 63 of the advances belong to the public sector banks. So this is a clear motive to hand over the public sector banks to their owners, which control these banks prior to 1969. Of course, the owners will be different. But the fact remains that this is a precursor to privatization. All this hullabaloo, this hype of getting amalgamated, having this big global banks. Even if all the banks are consolidated, we will not reach the size of a global bank. What we need today are good banks, not necessarily big banks. What has a merger of State Bank with its associates has taught us? For the first time in its history, State Bank posted a staggering loss of 6,547 crore in 2018. Till as of now, State Bank is yet to come out of that merger, the pangs of the merger. Thousands of branches have been closed. Our Honorable Finance Minister says that there will be no job loss. Of course, there will be no retrenchment. But people will be compelled to take voluntary retirements. Of course, if you resign on your own, it cannot be termed as termination. There will be pressure on the employees and officers because recruitment has stopped. And with the large scale closure of branches, there will be closure of branches. Why are we opposing? That is a moot question. Are we afraid of our jobs? No. We are afraid that the entire, as I said, the nation will be affected. The common people will be affected. The interest of the common man will be affected. Suppose the public sector banks are reduced in number, the number of branches will shrink, and this will yield space to the non-banking finance companies, the fintech companies who are wanting to get into that space at the cost of the public sector banks. And even in United States of America, there is a tremendous resentment of this against this merger of banks. The argument that they have put forth is that mergers of bank will lead to job losses. It's not only the employees. Millions of people are connected with the banks. Suppose 5 ATM counters are closed down. It means 5 security guards will be losing their job, losing their livelihood. And so many other people who are connected to the entire banking industry, they'll be out of work. And those numbers cannot be measured. Because we are looking at the numbers of the employees. And the government will say that nobody lost their jobs. But that's not the true story. That's not the fact. The fact is it will lead to gross unemployment. And it will not boost our economy in any case. Because whatever has been being propagated can only be driven by the public sector banks. Say in the United States of America, as of now, there are 5,000 banks operating. In Germany, 2,000 banks. In UK, there are 300 banks. In India, there are only 86 banks. With such a vast country, the country needs more banks, more number of public sector banks, more number of branches, so that it can reach out to the poorest of the poor. What is the credit outflow? It's coming down. Post 1991, the rural credit is coming down, the percentage. The corporates are enjoying the cream. Now, if you analyze the gross capital formation over the years, you'll find that capital formation is coming down, while gross NPA is coming up, is rising steeply. What does it mean? It means that the corporates are looting the public sector banks. National resources are being looted. The public sector banks does not belong to the government. They do not belong to the government. The owners of public sector banks is the state. The government is just an executive arm of the state that we have to understand. So that is why we are urging upon the common man. We are spreading this message across the country that let us fight. Let us fight against this narrative. Let us build up our strong opinion, like what we did for the FRDI bill. There it was a mass movement. Just because the mergers have been announced, it does not mean that a mergers will take place. If we can build up the momentum, we can involve the common people, the farmers, all the stakeholders together. Together we can resist. So that is our appeal to all our viewers, that come and protest against this draconian retrograde decision which will affect the social fabric of the country.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing with us why this bank merger is not only going to affect bank officers and employees, but also the citizens of this country who also have a stake in the public sector bank.
Everyone is a stakeholder. Everyone is a stakeholder. And we have to fight for our rights. We are ready for a struggle. We are ready for a fight.
Okay. Thank you for watching News.
Thank you.